Welcome back to Soda City Live. Richland Library has been leading conversations, embracing and discussing physical and cultural differences through Let's Talk Race. These honest conversations happen with people right here in our community and have become so successful that they've created a curriculum. Joining me today is Richland Library's Let's Talk Race facilitation team member, Heather McHugh, and marketing and communications director, Keosha Bowles. Ladies, thank you so much for joining me today.
Thank you for having us.
Such a pleasure. And I know, Heather, you've been involved with this since the beginning, close to the beginning,
right.
And Keosha, you're a lot newer to this, but I just want to know, Heather, from your experience, how you've seen this program just evolve.
It's been tremendous, and I always joke that I sort of like forced my way onto the team. I just started going to the conversations because I was so interested and I wanted the opportunity to connect with our community. So I just kind of started as a participant, and then we were holding kind of quarterly conversations, and our community was really coming and showing up and really engaged. And our constant question that we always got was like, when is the next conversation?
Yeah.
And people were always disappointed when we said, well, it'll be, you know, in a couple months or whatever. So we've been trying to really increase that. And then, of course, the pandemic happened,
yeah,
and the murder of George Floyd. So the importance of these conversations, we always knew they were important, but it really came to the forefront. So we really kicked it into high gear and started bringing in some real thought leaders like Jane Elliott, Ibram X. Kendi. We had monthly conversations online during that time. We started book groups, and we started other kinds of initiatives to make sure that we were having complete conversations about race, including our dinner table talks, to engage caregivers and parents so they could have conversations about race with their own children.
And, you know, this is such a unique approach to having this dialogue, because not many times would you know that, you know, hear that a library is going to be the one leading the charge. Now, when this initially started, was this something that was supposed to be like a one-time thing and it just, the popularity kind of created this wildfire? Or was this something that the library just intended to continue to have with conversations?
It really started, you know, again, I mentioned the murder of George Floyd.
Right.
We had the murder of Walter Scott here in our state. We had the AME shooting. We had the Confederate flag. We had all these issues bubbling up. And my colleague, Tamara King, went to our executive director, Melanie Huggins, and said, you know, this is really, you may not know, but this is really pressing on a lot of our staff.
Mm.
This is really in their minds. And everybody's not having the same experience with these kinds of events. And so that's really the genesis, is that conversation. Our executive director gave Tamara the green light to kind of get this team together and to start having these conversations. And we started with kind of a broader goal, but really what we kept coming back to is race, because I think there are so few opportunities to really talk about it in honest and vulnerable ways.
And it's a safe space, because like you said, when these events happen in the community, you have people on every side wanting to say something but not knowing what to say or how to say it. And this safe space gives you that opportunity to be able to have those conversations without judgment. And it's really and truly very educational. So I can understand how it's gained so much popularity. But I do want to make sure we talk a little bit more about this curriculum and what conversations since 2016, seven, 8 years have, you know, sparked this curriculum. I mean, were some of these conversations what, you know, sparked some of the topics in the curriculum?
So with the curriculum, like we mentioned, we've been having so many courageous conversations within the library system, and so many people want to know, how can we have these same conversations in their home, with their community, within their churches, within their organizations or nonprofit? And so what we did was compile a curriculum that provides individuals and organizations with the tools to have their own Let's Talk Race experience. So the curriculum provides them facilitation modules, it has starter packs, it has conversation guides, as well as tools and resources so that they can educate themselves and inform themselves so they can be more educated on this topic. And so we want to make sure that our community is prepared to have these courageous conversations, and we're working these muscles on an everyday basis so that we are prepared to talk about race, we're prepared to talk about injustices, and that we are opening those lines of dialogue throughout the year, you know, at all times, so that we are prepared when a moment arises.
That's amazing. And where can people get access to this curriculum?
So they can go to letstalkraceguide.com. They will be able to go there to find more information about the curriculum. They can sign up and then they will receive access to the curriculum. It is completely free. All they have to do is just give us a name and the information. We'll send them those details and they'll have full access to all of the resources and materials within the guide.
Perfect. Well, ladies, I want to thank you so much for joining us today. And will you guys continue to have those actual conversations as well? Like, is there a class coming up soon?
We have a conversation, actually. We partner with other organizations, so the Columbia Museum of Art. We're going to be having conversations about race around their Catawba pottery exhibit that's coming up. So that'll be in July.
Okay, awesome. And I'm sure, of course, the current events that are happening right now would probably be a part of that discussion as well. But we're going to take a quick break. And, of course, we have to have you back on because this is a great conversation. We're going to take a quick break. But first, we're going to go to Arvon Gaskin, who's standing by to let us know what we can expect this weekend for weather.